Today on Here for the Right Reasons, the happy new Bachelor Nation couple is here. Plus, what advice does JoJo Fletcher have for the new duo?
Don't focus on social media. Don't focus on people saying negative things, because it's going to happen. But you just got to trust in each other. Soak up this time together, because it is going to be so fun, so exciting to live your life.
Plus, Kayla Quinn is breaking down her thoughts on Greg and Katie's reunion.
I think people weren't empathizing with the feelings Greg had, and everyone just kept saying he's an actor, he's gaslighting. They were using a lot of accusatory words.
And of course, we're chatting all about last night's finale. We've got that plus so much more on today's Here for the Right Reasons. Hi guys, Mandy DeCamp here with Us Weekly senior editor Sarah Heron. Welcome to Here for the Right Reasons. It's the finale.
It's the finale, and wow, a lot of twists and turns.
It really was. I'm wearing my most dramatic season ever shirt. I don't know if it was the most dramatic season ever, but we'll get to that.
Yeah, there were highs and lows for everyone involved, I think.
Well, they seem happy. I mean, do you think this is going to last? Are you?
Oh, man, the tough question.
I know.
You know, listen, if they can make it through, I always say this, if they can make it through watching the season back and any backlash that's going to happen over the next couple weeks as people still talk about this, probably. But if there's a broken foundation, we'll find out. He seems like really proud of the way she handled herself. So that's good.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, if they can get through her aunt, I think they can get through a few trolls online.
I mean, if her aunt and mom even know. How weird is that? I know.
True, I know.
What the hell was that?
That was strange. Very, like, that was, how long has it been since they shot the finale? Do you know?
Last week in April.
So, wow, that's a little strange.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was supposed to wrap in May, but they finished early, which we saw Us Weekly confirmation. I know I'm jumping ahead here, but Us Weekly confirmation, because Tayshia called me Elaine. Yeah. So we knew that. So yeah, they finished at the end, or maybe end of April or May. Now I'm doubting myself, but either way, it's been a while. I think it was end of April.
Yeah, her mom and aunt should know at this point. Very strange.
Yeah, that's...
Okay, before we get more into that, you also sat down with OG Bachelorette JoJo Fletcher, and she gave some great advice for the couple. So let's hear what she had to say.
I have been really bad at being able to keep up. I don't have cable. I don't have the upgraded Hulu subscription, but I have followed along. And just last night when I kind of saw everything coming through about how it ended for her, I sent her a text and I congratulated her. And it's on the Bachelorette group chat that we all have. And it's just, you know what, as a former Bachelorette and knowing what that experience is like, and everyone's going to have an opinion, you know, you get to see a glimpse of kind of how everything played out and people make their perceptions. But at the end of the day, the fact that she was able to find love and she's happily engaged to Blake, that is something that we all wanted for Katie and are excited for her. And so we all congratulated her last night. And I think the main theme of, you know, when you wish the next Bachelorette well, it's kind of just like lean into each other. Don't focus on social media. Don't focus on people saying negative things, because it's going to happen. But you just got to trust in each other. Soak up this time together, because it is going to be so fun, so exciting to live your life. But also know this is when you start to, difficult times also come after the show. And so just know that and just continue to work at it every single day. But we're all super excited for her. And I'm sure she is just so happy to be done with it. And she said that she's happier and more in love than she's ever been. So that is really, really exciting.
Gotta love JoJo and Jordan. I mean, they're going strong. Nice to hear from her. I hope they get married soon.
I love them. I do. I'll say it again and again. I think that was a couple I didn't think was going to last. And how wrong we were. I mean, granted, they're still not married, but you know.
No, I totally agree. And because when you said like they're not, like when you asked me like just a few minutes ago about Katie and Blake, my instinct is always like no, but I'm always wrong. Like the ones I'm confident in are the ones that never work.
Yep.
So what do I know?
Yeah. You also chatted with Kayla Quinn. She had lots of thoughts about Greg, as did I, as did you, as did Bachelor Nation. So let's hear what she had to say about it.
I know I saw your tweet last week and you were very much feeling Greg last week, right? Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, I feel like last week and this week are a little different because now we know the ending. But last week, I just felt like everyone was, to be honest, ganging up on Greg and not seeing his side. And I know I love Katie because she's, you know, stands up for herself. She speaks her mind. And that's the Bachelorette Katie we love and adore. But at the same time, I think people weren't empathizing with the feelings Greg had. And everyone just kept saying he's an actor, he's gaslighting. They were using a lot of accusatory words, and I think not using, I don't know. I just felt like we all needed to like kind of listen to the words he was saying. And when you went to the root of it, it was just that Greg wanted this whole experience to be real. He didn't want, you know, to feel like there were walls put up, that she was in a role. He wanted to feel like it was just the two of them. And Katie stood her guns and wanted to stay in the bachelorette role, which we all can respect. And so that miscommunication, that misalignment is where all of the conflict started.
Yeah, that is 100% true. I think that it was interesting to see, because when we first of all, they teased it. The way they ordered this whole thing really kind of confused me. I think the same way you and I are talking about Greg right now, we should have just closed that in the beginning. I don't think it made any sense for us to be watching all of the Blake stuff and then go right to Greg and then try to bring it back to Blake. I think it was unfair for everyone to like, and even the viewers, to try to follow that narrative and then be happy for them. Whether you like agreed with Katie or Greg or not, I just don't think that was the right way to structure the show.
I agree. Like when you go through a breakup, you want that closure first before you can move on. And they're like trying to make us, you know, date someone while we're still heartbroken. Cause us as audiences are heartbroken for Katie, because we're all rooting for that relationship. So there's just so much happening at once.
So much happening at once. And it was obviously pre-taped, which I don't always love either, cause you never know what we're missing. That the live part of After the Final Rose is always like, just like an adrenaline rush, I feel like.
Yeah. Yes.
And everyone, this was felt a little more like pre-planned out, which I get, but Katie came in guns blazing. I mean, when we saw her first talk to Caitlin and Tayshia alone, you could tell she was still upset. From everything I understand, and after the Final Rose situation, they had just maybe watched the episode, like even backstage too. So she maybe gets a little fired up. The producers are talking to you. They're reminding you about how heartbroken you were, even if you're happy with Blake. She gets out there and immediately doesn't even interact with him for the greeting. And I think he was thrown off. I don't know if he was just naive or just hoping that she was going to come out and not worry, like not go hard on him. But either way, he was shocked. You could tell the second she didn't acknowledge him when she walked out on the stage.
No, you're right. And I've been in that situation before. They really do bring you back to that moment.
They bring
you back to the breakup seconds before. And they're like, do you remember that feeling you had? Do you remember the last words that were said? This is what happened. So if there's anything you want to say, the producers always tell you, get it out now. And so I think Katie wanted to, not only for herself, but for all the women out there who have been spoken in an aggressive manner, I think she wanted to stand up for herself, and it was all pent up. And you're right, she did take it all out on him, and you could feel pain, anger. We all saw it. It did feel like she wasn't over her conversation with Greg. And I feel like, I don't know, it was a little much to me.
Yeah, you can hear my whole recap with Kayla on the Here for the Right Reasons podcast. She has been very vocally Team Greg. I know we left last week, you and I, not really sure where we stood. And I think it would be a disservice to everyone if we didn't just start with Greg and how awkward everything was with him.
Absolutely. Let's just get right into it. So I went back and forth so many times on last night's episode. First, I was like, oh, Team Katie, 100%. He was totally acting. But then she really made him a villain. And I'm like, I don't know if he deserves to be a villain. Yeah. Like, the guy, I mean, this is just my opinion, but at the end of the day, she cannot say for a fact that he was acting. And right. She was acting like it was factual information. Like, he is an actor in acting school and this was an act. That might be very true, but it very well may not be true. He maybe just needed that reassurance to stick around. So it was kind of like his word versus her word. And I just felt like she was acting like it was factual, like he's a bad guy. And I couldn't stand behind that.
Yeah, I definitely think Katie was riled up, which like, and I get it, because I mean, I've heard from people before that right out of the After the Final Rose, like you watch everything play out, like you don't see it until right then. So Katie like must have just seen her finale.
It sounds like she watched it backstage.
Right. She watched it backstage, and they always do this. Like you go back to like Melissa Rycroft, remember? She's like, they made her cry right before because she had to watch like the proposal with Jason and then had to get out there. So she got in her feels again. Blake Hortzman has told me that before. So like, it's definitely a thing where they get you all riled up backstage.
Totally.
And she certainly was. The thing about Greg that I mean, it confuses me. There's a million things, but like when he first was talking to Tayshia and Caitlyn before she even came out, I was like, oh, he is either trying to downplay this all because he doesn't want it to turn into a thing. But like he had no idea what he was in for. So was he acting then to like, was he just, did he really genuinely think that because Katie was engaged now, she wasn't going to like come swinging with the way things ended? Because I was just like, come on, dude. Like he didn't show the same way when they broke up and he, you know, just like walked away and refused to like listen to her. I feel like it was almost that same vibe too. Like he went into it thinking like, all right, like I'm just gonna, you know, try to brush this aside. We'll get through it. When like she came out with all the emotions, it almost made me be like, okay, he didn't care that much. Like he's not like giving in. I don't know.
Yeah. I see what you're saying. I mean, I think if he knew Katie at all, he would know that she was going to come out pretty strong, especially knowing that she had just watched it. I will quote my favorite housewife though, Lisa Rinna, and say like, you're so angry, Katie. Yes. What's up with that? Like you should be happy with Blake now. Why are you so angry?
I you know, totally agree. If I was Blake, and he kind of, when he came out, and also, I mean, jumping ahead, but when she like grabbed him and like made out with him, I was like, okay, she's trying to prove it now. And I'm like, oh boy. And I totally get it. Like she's in a tough spot because she's pissed and she is reliving these emotions and she wants to be like, F you to Greg.
Yeah.
And she feels these things, but at the same time, like it was maybe a little too angry
for her.
So happy. I also, one thing I didn't believe when he said, because like you're right, the acting stuff is so interesting, and I didn't like his like laughing about it. Like I just was like, okay, he's coming off a little smug to me. Like he didn't really come off super sincere. And I don't believe him when he said that he didn't know he was gonna leave when they had their second conversation on the show before he quit. And he was like, I was hoping to get back on the same page. That's just not true. Because if he was, he would have like explained himself versus this like awkward disconnect. And like she said, not saying goodbye and walking away and being dramatic. But then at the same time, I agree with him. He's not Meryl Streep. So I don't think this whole thing was an act, but I kind of think maybe he was waiting for an out. I don't think he would have quit.
You might be right. Yeah. That was a big point that she brought up, that you just didn't want this suddenly. And this was your way of showing that instead of just stepping away. That could be very true. I don't know. I think this is one that's going to be one we don't know. I want to know though.
I know. I think we're going to see a lot of interviews coming out, if I had to guess, in the next couple like days as they do their press rounds and stuff. And I think that, you know, the claim specifically about Greg being like a confident, cocky boy from Jersey, who knows he's like hot shit versus like the shy guy on the show, that's stuff that I've been like hearing also.
Yeah.
But like, there's no way to prove something like that.
Right. And that's the whole thing about this.
Yeah, right. You can't trust maybe a scorned ex-girlfriend. I'm not saying that none of these people are willing to go on the record from anything I've experienced or tried to do, you know, as a journalist, that's what you want to call me in this moment. But so I get it, because she's frustrated and she sees all this stuff on the internet, but it's like, it's hard with the blind gossip of it all. Like, do you want to believe that? Or do you want to believe the person you supposedly got to know? Like, I don't know. And if he didn't leave the way he did, I think she would have maybe had his back. But the fact that he walked out I also didn't know, like, do you think when you were watching it, do you think it was for him, like the flip the switch moment? Because then he tried to say that it wasn't. But I really did, watching it back, it really did feel like he flipped based on her response to that whole thing, which whether you think that was right or wrong is a whole other issue. But he's then tried to pretend that he was having these doubts earlier.
Right.
I don't know.
Even though she had given him the one-on-one and all of that. Yeah, like several one-on-ones, first impression rose, all of that. I mean, I don't think it was a flip the switch moment, really. I don't. I think that... I mean, the more I talk about it, the more I think that maybe he just wasn't that into her.
Yeah, I kind of think that's what it is too. Yeah. But I think maybe he, to quote Lisa Rinna again, needed to own it.
Yeah.
Like watching it back.
Yeah. I mean, he did maybe make up this narrative. Okay, fine. Yeah. Fine. I'm not Team Greg. But the problem with it all is like, none of it makes him a villain, you know? And she made him a villain. And it's like, well, maybe I want to see him as Bachelor. You're kind of like writing him off in Bachelor Nation. Like he's this bad guy. Like he's Jed.
I don't think he's Josh Murray. Like, I don't think he's like quite as, I don't know. I think also he just did a bad job because like again, she came in swinging and some people are definitely thinking she was too harsh, but I don't think he showed like a good side of him really either. He couldn't get mad because then that would have backfired too. So I get that. Yeah. But like the kind of laughing when she was talking about the acting thing and the, I don't know. Like I wasn't getting total sincerity from him in a moment where like he was an actor, he should have cried or something.
Yeah. The audience took his side at one point. Did you hear that? The audience totally clapped for him at one point.
They were having like a cheer battle.
Yeah. It was good. The audience gets my rose last night.
Agreed. And Caitlin honestly did a great job. That the podcast host in her was coming out because she was like probing, leading the conversation. Tayshia didn't say one word during the entire Greg Katie fight, which I wonder how long that was in real life, because that felt like a circling around moment.
Yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, you're right. They edited some stuff out. Definitely. All right, so we move on to Justin.
Let's talk about Justin for a second.
Yeah. What do you think about Justin?
Poor Justin. Yeah. I will say two of my like one-liner highlights from the episode was when at the beginning, when Justin found out that Greg left, and he straight up just said, I don't know what's going on. Everything feels so odd. I'm anxious, but it would be pointless for me to speculate because I literally have zero clue. Like, Justin, that's exactly, you know, how we all feel about you. And when he turned to her at their After the Round Rose and was like, I would love to be a fly on the wall for that one, talking about Greg. Because it's like, I like Justin, and I feel like it was so silly it felt like to him to be there, but she did try to give him that validation during After the Final Rose that like you weren't just the constellation. Yeah. But it feels so silly after, you know, the Mike Leigh confession that she was had he left and the Greg of it all for her to try to tell him that he was final too.
Yeah. What I didn't understand is telling the producers, making him do all the like, I'm ready to take that next step with Katie. I'm ready to do this. I'm so excited for our one-on-one. And to lead up right until the one-on-one, like why make him get ready, put on the nice outfit, go find him in his hotel room and tell him while he's brushing his teeth. Like, why did you get
because they were so ahead of schedule,
right? And
they needed one person left and we already got, I mean, the worst part of this episode, I think, and nothing against Katie and Blake, was just like them still going on dates. Like I feel like half the episode was them on a date when I'm like, we're dealing with this intensity of knowing that we have the Greg confrontation to come, even the Justin like breakup to come. Like I didn't need to keep watching them go on dates and like burn stuff.
No, I know. That was
a filler. So imagine if she let him go even earlier than him getting
ready. I know. I did think about that. I'm like, they're filling content. That's why the aunt was there too.
But, oh God. Yeah.
I felt bad for him. I mean, my thing with Justin is I almost called him Jason because like, truthfully, his name could be Jason. That's how well we know him. Like we just don't know him well.
I kind of feel bad for him though, because he did say like, I was shocked that he said he was blindsided by her like sending him home.
Well, they did say there was a lot of moments that were cut out from them.
Right. That's why I kind of feel bad for him, because he's quickly, I mean, at least he's the comic relief in like a very tense episode. And two part, I mean, from last week to this, it's just been very tense. I don't think this has really been super fun because everyone's also on edge of like fighting about the Greg thing.
Yeah.
So I think that he's gotten, like, he got a good edit in that way, but I also kind of just feel bad for him because he's like kind of become the butt of the joke of the season.
Yes, but I know nothing about him.
And when she was like, the painting made me so happy.
I totally forgot about that. Wait, let's talk about that. What, like, she did, that was such a serious moment, and she was like, your painting. I'm like, you looked at it every day? Like, it really?
I know. And that
would be true.
He tried to be tough, and then we got in the car, like, when he kind of started crying, like, I don't know. I wish he went to Paradise because I think he would have maybe had a good time. I don't think he's ever going to be The Bachelor, so we should have.
I don't either. Between the past tweets that he had, which, you know, he's apologized for, I think. But I don't think he's going to be the next Bachelor, so bye, Justin. Maybe next season of Bachelor in Paradise.
Yeah, by the way, that quick promo, can we talk about the Kufrin, the Tia, the Kendall? Yeah. I'm so ready.
Kendall and Joe are getting back together. If you look back a few episodes ago, I believe I said this. And
I don't think they're getting back together, but I'm excited.
They are. Did you see the way he was holding her? They're totally getting back together. And Becca, I'm so excited about that.
And Thomas,
that looks good too. And I'm excited about David Spade.
And honestly, the Yale Little Johns were getting me going.
Yeah.
I'm ready. I'm here for it. I don't miss Chris Harrison. Sorry. I really don't.
Next week?
Yeah. No breaks.
I'm so excited.
No weeks off in Bachelor Nation.
And that's fine with me.
But then, of course, Katie and Blake.
All right.
Okay. So before we get into like the actual proposal, what did you think of the I guess the meeting with her family was the big thing. Like I said, the other little dates, they were just kind of like whatever, but they were like dropping these little hints of him having doubts. But she also, she said, I love you before he met the family, right?
Yes.
Because that was kind of big that she broke her own rule, broke her and Greg up.
Right. That was cool. And what also was cool is that Blake knew he was the only guy left. That's something different I feel like they hadn't done in the past. Because doesn't usually when she eliminates the one guy, the guy who's still there thinks that guy's still there?
Well, did he know Justin was gone?
I think he did. I think at some point he said, I'm the only guy left, and there that adds like pressure or whatever.
Oh, when she met the family. Well, I will say also, I think the smartest thing Katie did all season was tell him about the Greg and Michael A like comment she made that she like wanted to quit, because
that was,
imagine watching that back. I mean, it still was probably hard to watch that back because there was like so many emotions, and she obviously didn't go into like her being like on the bathroom floor.
You don't really know, but
yeah. Well, yeah. And she could have said more, and that's only they showed, but like, I feel like that was the smartest thing she ever did. And his reaction to that, which I think it's really only because probably, or not only, but a huge reason is because he's been on the show before. So he knows what it's like, and like kind of had to expect her. She was going to say, I love you to other, not that she said, I love you to other people, but like, those are the two things I think they have going for them, that she told him in advance, and he reacted well because he like respects this show, maybe probably more than he should, but he does. And that she only ended up saying, I love you to him in the end. So those two things they can hold on to, and they'll always have, and they don't have to like, you know, as they watch this back, because it's definitely hard to watch this back.
And then, I would not be okay with any of it. I mean, if I saw my significant other crying on the bathroom floor about another guy and thinking about leaving, I don't
know. But like, you went on The Bachelor. So like, what do you want? That's why like, I always get, I know it's like a bad narrative to be like, this is what you signed up for, but a huge part of me always thinks that. Like, Greg should have never been on the show to begin with.
Yeah.
If he didn't think he could handle it. Like, sorry, like Blake can. And in the end, he won out. Whether they're going to live happily ever after, I don't know. But you have to be like tough enough.
Yeah. Okay, meeting the family. What is this aunt? I mean, she was intense, saying everything was cute. Oh, that's cute. That's cute.
She was kind of rude.
Rude, totally rude.
I want to know her relationship history and everything, whatever, because at least these people are putting themselves on the line. And like, what is he supposed to say?
Right. Like, she wanted like concrete like examples of how they were going to work it out. He's like, and like talk through things. And she's like, no, cute, that's cute. I'm like, oh my God.
You're married. Is that what you're supposed to do? Like, I mean, what is he supposed to say? Like, we're going to make a pro con.
Right. No, we don't like plan future fights and how we're going to deal with them. Like, that's not a thing. I mean, they should probably talk about Canada and Africa and all of that. I mean, that is kind of a big conversation to have. And if they hadn't had that conversation, that's something they should probably talk about.
I agree. I thought that was super telling because in last week's episode, Greg did say to his family, we already talked it out. And like, she's coming to New York. And then with the Blake situation, it was like, oh, well, maybe we'll live forever. I'll make it work. I don't care. Like, I'll do anything for him. It's like, really? Because you're moving to New York with Greg last week. Like,
She's like, I don't want to move to Canada. That's why.
Yeah, probably. But also, it was interesting to me when she was like, yeah, if he's gone for a month, like, that's cool with me. I'm like, oh, it is.
Yeah.
Weird comment.
What does he do? Do you know?
He's like a wildlife expert. Hmm. So he like travels and like helps animals.
Cool.
Yeah. And also interesting with like, I'm all for like girl power, feminism, like, yeah, like you shouldn't, you know, rely on a man too much, whatever. But like, I think her mom and aunt just hate men.
Yeah. I kind of got that vibe too. I feel like it didn't matter who Blake was. And I think they even said that. They were like,
yeah, no, they did.
They were basically like, you mean nothing to us.
Which is so kind of
strange. Like, I don't know if it was like produced that way or if that's how they really are. At the end of the day, no one's forcing them to say this stuff. They said it, and it was bizarre to me. And maybe that's why I shouldn't share the engagement news with them.
Yeah, like I'd be pissed at them if they acted that way. But then at the end, the mom seemed to come around, and it was kind of cute when she was like,
yeah. Oh,
the aunt must get the mom all riled up. And then when she was alone with him, she was like, okay, like let's like maybe be real here. It was weird. I don't know.
It was very strange. I've never
seen what else was weird was the actual proposal.
Yeah. Okay. So what did you think about Blake's hesitation? Was it produced? Was it real?
I think Blake's hesitation was probably pretty produced. I'm sure he was definitely nervous and like the rings and stuff, but we see those guys have those moments all the time. And Tayshia really jumped to conclusions when she was all like, maybe you have to let her go. I'm like,
yeah, but I mean, they always almost got me for a second. I was like, wait, is Blake going? Because then it is the most dramatic season. But
oh my God, imagine if Katie was dumped. Imagine if Katie was dumped by three of her top four. That would have been.
That would have been nuts.
That would have been really sad, honestly.
That would have been. That's what, I don't know. I felt like it was produced. I felt like he was pretty into her.
I think so too. And I think even if, by the way, if he decided he didn't want to propose because he was clearly nervous, and like, I get it. Like that part is always interesting. Like if they decide they want to commit or not, like propose, I get that argument because it is, then you have to go back to real life and you have to be like, okay, I know I'm on the show, but like ever since they broke the rules where you don't have to really get engaged anymore. I do get the feeling when they just decide to date, like that's like, yeah. I don't think that's
they don't get that Neil Lane ring.
Right. And I would be a little disappointed probably if I was the lead, but I also would be like, oh, look, I picked someone realistic. Like there's good sides to both of that if they decide to date or whatever. But Tayshia being like, we might have to let her go if you're not ready to propose. I was like, that's an extreme. Are you kidding?
I thought I missed something. I was like, wait, they didn't, what? I thought this was just like a cute little like gimmicky thing, which it was, yeah, obviously.
And then when he was doing the proposal and he had that long pause, I was like, did he get like slipped a bonus to make this like he was gonna walk away for the promo or something?
You're like, we really need to fill 3 hours, so
yeah. I thought if I was her, I'd be like, hi, I'd be pissed if that was my like the proposal. Like I remember the Tayshia Zach one with like so many feels, and I didn't even really like him that much during the season, but I was like bawling.
Yeah,
this one I didn't really get an emotion.
I'll tell you when I did get emotion, and I hate myself for it.
Not the song.
The song. I got legit chills. It was a little cold in my house, but I think they were from the radios.
Bandy.
I know. Sarah, I chills. Actual chills in my arm. I was like, stop. What is that? I'm so mad at myself.
I would have gotten chill. I mean, no, I wouldn't have, but like if the band came out or something, cool.
Yeah.
The people in the audience and that dumb song. Oh God, I got the opposite of chills. I was like, let's go. Let's get to the Paradise promo.
Stop to me too. I know. But that's when I was like, maybe they are going to make it.
Right,
I know. But wait, I also need to talk about his tight pants and the horse. I mean, why are his pants so tight? Why? Just get looser pants.
The fashion, I mean, Katie's outfits, Tayshia's weird outfit. There was so much going on that I was like
Katie's dress though, her finale dress, the green. I really
did you?
That. I did. I actually
it was a little. It was a little Little Mermaid for me personally.
All right, that's fair.
But it was just. I didn't. I liked when it was like flowing in the wind.
Yeah, and it wasn't white, which a lot of them were white.
Yeah, I wish it was white.
Yeah. All right. Well,
these two, I will say, from the beginning, since they saw each other, they do have a connection. I don't know if it's purely physical, and they are very similar. I mean, the fact that when they were dropping the "I love yous," they both threw an F-bombs in there.
Yeah,
maybe they really are soulmates, and we'll find out.
Maybe we will find out. I'm rooting for them, and yeah, I guess we'll see you next week for Bachelor in Paradise, Sarah.
Oh my God, I hope we have an update on Katie and Blake already by then. I mean, Claire and Dale are still together. Who knows?
Anything can happen. All right, good season. Thank you, Sarah.
Bye, guys.
Bye.